In this video, I want to show you how to run a power analysis using G-Power for the correlation coefficient. And what we're going to do in this video is focus on determining the necessary sample size to obtain a certain amount of power given an effect size. Okay, and that's the most common way to do a power analysis, where I want to know how many people do I need in my study to have a good chance or good power at getting a significant result. Okay, so how many people do I need to have a good chance at getting significance if there really is a true correlation in the population? Let me show you what I mean here. So this is G power, and if I go under test family and I select exact, then notice what comes up: correlation bivariate normal model. That's what I want for just the ordinary Pearson R correlation coefficient. And for type of power analysis, I do want a priori, and this is what I was saying, compute required sample size. So how many people do we need? If I provide the alpha, like 0.05, the power level that I'm interested in, and I'm going to go ahead and put in 80% or 0.80, and then the effect size. And for the effect size for correlation, the typical or standard effect sizes as proposed by Cohen were 0.1 for small, 0.3 for medium, and 0.5 for large. Okay, so let's move this, and I'm going to run a two-tailed test, which allows for either a significant positive or a significant negative correlation. And then here is, what is my correlation in the population? And this I have to just estimate. It would be best to estimate it based on previous research. I'm going to go ahead and show you the sample size required for small, medium, and large effect sizes. Okay, here this is our alpha level, so we'll use the standard of 0.05. And then here's power. Now, this to me is way too high. In reality, we don't try and run power analyses with a 95% chance of getting significant or a power of 0.95. The highest I usually see is 0.80. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in. And we are testing against a null hypothesis of zero correlation, which is our most commonly used hypothesis value for correlation by far. So our first analysis we're going to run is for a medium effect size, or an effect size of 0.3. Go ahead and click calculate. And here I can see the number of people required to obtain significance. So here it's 84 people are required if I really have a medium effect in the population. If I go ahead and run the study, if I sample 84 people, I will have an 80% chance of getting significance, which also implies, on the other side of the coin, a 20% chance of not getting significance. Okay, now this assumes that the true correlation in the population is 0.3 between the two variables. Okay, let's try this for a large effect size, and you can see a pattern here. If I go to 0.5, with all these same conditions, previously for a medium effect size, my sample size required was 84. Now it drops all the way to 29, which is quite doable in most research that I see. 29 people is not really asking that much. In some situations, it is, like perhaps brain research or what have you. But 29 in the work I do, a lot of survey research and other studies, that's not usually a problem at all. So if I have a large effect size, I will only need 29 people to have an 80% power, or an 80% chance of getting significance, if the true population value really is 0.5. Now let's finish up here with a small effect size. And here it gets a little bit less encouraging. I'll show you what I mean. So the same conditions everywhere else. Click calculate. Notice how many people that we need if we have a small effect size. If our true correlation in the population is 0.1 between our two variables, and I run a study and I want 80% power, then I'm going to need 782 people in order to have an 80% chance of getting significance. That's pretty tough. I don't see a lot of studies with that many people. So a lesson that you can pull from this is that with small effect sizes in research, it can be quite hard to get significance. With medium and large effect sizes, there's a lot greater chance of getting significant results in your studies. But in conclusion, this power analysis can be done for any type of test, t-test, correlation, ANOVAs, and many others, regression, and so on. And you can obtain, using these options here, the sample size required for a given effect size input. Okay, that's it. Thanks for